to the next conversation of the day. You're just in time for this conversation on choosing a career, selecting a career. How best can you get a career that you love? Is it okay to just to choose one and leave in the middle of a course and then get another? Well, today we have a conversation with Lois Achayo Baraka. She is an advocate of the High Court of Kenya. She's a teacher by profession also, a YouTuber. Akona profiling in there. Huh? Lois, karibu sana.
Asante sana. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure having you. Thank you so much. I know it's a cold morning. I hear people complaining about lonely baridi sana.
Mm-hmm.
But thank you for finding time. You teach also professionally.
Yes.
Where do you teach at?
Karura SDA School, History, Religion. But that is now part-time, like over the weekends, because I'm not, as much as I'm a trained teacher, graduated from Kenyatta University in 2017, I do not teach completely because of the advocacy. I have to be attending courts and all that. So basically, it's just trying to juggle the two.
So you did two courses?
Yes.
Education and law?
And law concurrently.
Concurrently?
Yes.
So at what point did you say that... as a person, you mm-hmm. want to become a lawyer and a teacher, you know, didn't you get confused at some point? For most parents, mm-hmm. they normally say, chagua moja.
Chagua moja.
How was it for you?
True. For me, it all begins with those childhood dreams that we all have.
Uh-huh.
Mine was and always has been being an advocate. And I remember I used to say I want to be a lawyer because we didn't know there was something called an advocate. So uh-huh. I grew up having that in mind. But the moment I cleared Form 4, I managed to get a B+, and the job placement placed me to do education at Kenyatta University.
Uh-huh.
So I remember I was a little bit angered. I felt this is not what someone else is choosing a career for me.
And which should not be the case.
Which shouldn't be the case. And since I'm coming from a disadvantaged family mm-hmm. in terms of finances and all that, my mom was like, we are going to, they will be paying only 13,000 for your school fees. So that is much better than us going to pay over 100,000 for a different course.
In law.
So I said, fine, if this is where fate has decided for me, I'll mm-hmm. do it. So in the middle of the course, I then got the West Pokot County Government, because I had studied in West Pokot, a school called Tashtar Girls, together with the school.
That was in high school?
Yes. Uh-huh. Having been their head girl and done well, they reached out to help sponsor a course, to help my mom sponsor a course that I will be able to undertake. So I picked on law. And then I figured, since I was already a year through the education program, and I felt that I liked it because it meant I was going to impact the young lives, mm-hmm. because I feel... as women, we grow up, some of us decide to become mothers along the way. And mm-hmm. the first teacher to your children is actually yourself. So yeah, I figured this will be a personal course even to my own children. Mm-hmm. And that's how I started juggling the two and graduated from law school in 2018, education 2017.
Wow. Wow. Mungu ni nani?
Mungu ni nani?
Who is God?
Okay.
And remember, as we continue with this conversation about choosing a career, ask her any question. You know, she's here for you.
Mm-hmm.
She normally does online videos on YouTube.
Yes.
What are they about?
They're about access to justice in terms of law, just trying to make sure that during the recent CJ interviews, the question that used to come up was in terms of the common mwananchi really does not even understand the judiciary except the time that he or she has to come before court. So mine is just to make the law accessible and to demystify the myth that law is expensive, lawyers are expensive. So I'm trying to put it out there that you can have this access to information. Even as you go to your advocate, at least you have something to bargain with. You don't go there full-flatted like, I don't know what I want. I want my lawyer just to advise me.
And ignorance is not a defense.
It's no defense in law.
Not up on Why in the morning is the hashtag? Why in the morning? Give us your take in regards to this. Ask your questions. She's here. She can answer all your questions when it comes to choosing a career. How best can you select a course that is worthwhile for you? Are you a parent? Tell your son or your daughter to tune into this particular conversation and ask questions before achague course ambayo atakuja kujuta katikati. You've seen students back out of their courses in the middle. Why do they do that? This is a conversation that will help you make better decisions, career decisions for you and for yourself. And Baraka, I'm looking at what you said earlier.
Mm-hmm.
As a child, when someone asks you, what do you want to be? What was your answer back then?
Back then, I remember that question vividly well when I was in Standard 4. Huh. And I remember I told my teacher of English, I want to be a lawyer.
Uh-huh. But so this law was in the system
it was in the system. But what they didn't tell me is that there's more to life than just being a lawyer. You know, I answered that question as if becoming a lawyer will be my ultimate goal. So should I achieve that, then that's over. But here I am, I've become a lawyer, proceeded to become an advocate of the High Court, but life still has to move on. There are other things I have, with the corona pandemic, there are things I have to do to supplement my law skills, to supplement my teaching skills. So the career journey is actually more diverse than how we make children feel like it's this direct.
Does the society normally do a lot of profiling when it comes to selecting careers? You know, do we have some preferences that we ought not to have as a society when it comes to choosing a career, so that we want our children to become XYZ and not ABC?
That's a good question. Actually, villages where we come from, every parent wants their daughter or their son to either become a doctor, an advocate,
engineer.
Rarely will you even hear the teacher part, apart from us who are brought up by teachers, so our parents were like, lazima pia ukwe mwalimu.
You were brought up by a teacher?
Yes, both parents were teachers.
Uh-huh.
So you find that there are those, like you're saying, the society has profiled these careers for these particular individuals. But so everyone is working towards that. And then we forget there are so many careers which are even doing much better, way better, depending on the personality of your particular child within that given society. Mm-hmm. So when we force things the way of our children, then that is where we go wrong as a society. Mm-hmm. It's about looking at what has the society offered. This person is coming from Turkana. There are so many oil gases being right now, there are so many from Turkana. Mm-hmm. So the question becomes, since this child has already interacted with oil at a physical and more formal way, then this person should be able, we should allow this person explore, come to the university, do energy. We don't all have to go and do law. You see?
We don't all have to go and become doctors. And you know, there's this belief that some courses are better than others. Is that true? Do you subscribe to that notion?
That is very false. I can tell you for real, I'm in the advocacy field, and it all depends with how great your mind is, how willing you are to push. Don't just think simply because I'm an advocate, I'm going to sit, be fine, tell people, yes, I'm an advocate, and then at the end of the day, I have my salaries are being paid, my bills are being paid. No, it's all about how badly can you push yourself. So there's nothing like a good career that will pay your bills. It's about your own will, your own zeal
so
as an individual.
So there's no good career and bad career.
There's no good career and bad career.
Maneno kwa kichwa. There's no good career and bad career. Remove it from your head and remove it from your belief system. Any career is a good career, depending on how versatile you are.
Yes.
When it comes to a Form 4 leave, they still, you know, when you're young, ulisema unataka kuwa lawyer.
Yeah.
Mimi nilisema unataka kuwa daktari. Where am I? We are to kopa na wewe.
Tukukwa studio.
But I had different options growing up.
Yeah.
At my first option, initially, I said I wanted to be a doctor. Mm-hmm. I later changed and said I wanted to be an architect. Mm-hmm. I later on went and changed and said I wanted to be a journalist. Leaving Form 4, I had two options, either law. I had three options, either law, architecture, or journalism. Mm-hmm. I chose journalism at the end of the day because that is what I chose for myself. Mm-hmm. But there are many who leave high school and they are confused on the kind of course they are going to choose. Mm-hmm. And some parents normally say, we need help. Who can advise my son? Who can advise my child? Is it okay if a parent chooses a course for their son or their daughter? And is how far should an advice on career go for a child who's just finished Form 4?
Thank you again for the question. So when it comes to how we incorporate parents into the career choices of our children, remember there's this saying in the community that goes, mzazi wako ameishi sana, anajua mengi. So they know what is
kukuliko.
Yes, they know what is best for you. But for me, it's always about incorporating that part of the statement into, let's just give advice. The more we can do as a parent is give advice, depending on or based on the fact that you're saying you've lived for a very long time, and you understand the dynamics of life better.
Even if the child is confused.
Even if we are advising. That's why we are trying to get him off that confusion through an advice. Then from there, let the child now be able to, because at Form 4, I'm assuming we are dealing with around 18-year-olds, 17-year-olds, 20-year-olds.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. As far as we can even go all the way to 25, this person has their own values which they subscribe to. They have their own strengths as an individual, which they know much better compared to you, because most of the time, even we send our children to boarding, we don't even interact with them. Mm-hmm. But you want to purport now, at such a time when they now want to make a decision, you want to be part of it and become militarian in terms of you have to do this, forgetting that your child either is more of an introvert. This child mm-hmm. rarely speaks a lot, but mm-hmm. when it comes to writing or something of the sort,
they're good in writing.
So do you know, like, you can, this person can actually end up being a great author. We'll celebrate their books. We'll be able to understand the dynamics of good reading. Get a segment in the newspaper. He'll be able to contribute into columns. Rather than force this individual into becoming a lawyer, this person appears in front of court and cannot even be able to express themselves. It doesn't mean this girl or this boy is a failure. It only means that when it comes to speech, they are a little bit slow. They take time to formulate words in their brain, and that means they can only write better rather than speak. So when we force a particular course to people just simply because we feel that is the best for them as parents, that's where we go wrong. Mm-hmm. Let's just be there in terms of advising our children. This is good. This is so and so. Such and such a person did this and was able to progress. Tell me, young girl, young boy, tell me, mama, like how they used to call them, tell me, baba, what are your values? This person will be able to tell you, me, my values is being in a place where people are hardworking, being in a place where people are resilient. And when you can be able to interrogate all those values, now place your child into a career that will be able to flourish that particular inner self, to be able to grow, rather than concentrating only on the outer self at the expense of the inner person of an individual.
Mm-hmm.
So parents, let's just advise, and then but the final decision, let's give it up for these children. Let them go and try. I mean, sisi wote tunajaribu tunaanguka.
And you know, I am also reminded of the fact that sometimes when a parent gives birth,
mm-hmm.
and lazima ni engineer,
mm.
you know, you've already selected a career path for your child
mm-hmm.
at birth. When you introduce your child, let's say anaitwa Baraka,
mm-hmm.
somebody, that is engineer Baraka, mm-hmm. akopi engineer Baraka kuja salimia watu,
mm-hmm.
na Baraka is still in Sunday school.
Yes.
Is that wrong?
That is not wrong. For me, I feel you are only, every person is supposed to speak good words towards a particular individual.
Mm-hmm.
That one can be able to propel this individual to greater heights. He doesn't have to become an engineer, mm-hmm. but trust me, he will not fall less of someone to be respected in a society. Mm-hmm. So the moment we start saying this person is an engineer, then what are you doing as a parent? You know, you're just saying he's an engineer. Then you've abandoned your child into some boarding school where every program is so tight. The only thing they do is math, English, Swahili, go and sleep. You are not even providing that environment when they come back for holiday to be able to interact, be a builder, use his hands or her hands to be able to build things, so that we are building that engineer. We're mm-hmm. not just saying. So it's about words matching your actions. You're mm-hmm. saying your child is an engineer. You've given birth to an engineer. Provide the environment. We have now the CBC curriculum. Make sure as they're coming from school with those particular homeworks that they have been given, take part in it. Make sure that you are more inclined into the engineering kind of virtues.
Aha.
Yes.
Aha. Daktari. Mm-hmm. Nimeza daktari.
Mm-hmm.
Some say nimeza bishop.
Mm-hmm.
But bishop is a career anyway. But when a parent is in this particular conversation with a child, and as a parent you want your child to select a particular career but your child doesn't want that, how should that conversation be packaged,
mm-hmm.
whereby you are advising your child
mm-hmm.
or your in regards to a particular line of thought,
mm-hmm.
but they don't subscribe to your belief,
mm-hmm.
how should parents relate and how should children relate also, so that this particular conversation ends up being positive at the end of the day, wasikorofishane,
mm-hmm.
and they end up disagreeing and leaving the room.
Sure, and actually most of them will even run away from home,
mm-hmm.
simply because we are trying to choose a career for a child.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, since this is the parent who gave birth to you, this is the parent who has seen you grown, trust me, they have seen one or two things about you. So the moment the results are first out, so we are first starting from there, we have results with us. Remember, there are courses that can only be undertaken, especially here in Kenya, based on a certain grade. So, for instance, let's say an averagely a student has gotten a C+. That is like, during my time, that was the minimum for you to get into a university. But remember, right now we have TVET institutions.
Yeah.
So it's not all lost. You with your D+, you can still be able to be enrolled into a polytechnic and be able to do a course and even achieve much further than a person who went through university. So it's about sitting your child down as a parent,
mm-hmm.
bringing your options, your options as a parent. I want you to be this, I want you to be that, I want you to be. And then the child also comes with their list of the things that they themselves, the careers that they themselves have wanted for themselves.
So it means you should ask them,
yes,
what do you want
these
to
are
be?
Mine. These you, are mine. What do you want to be? So you'll find more often than not, you'll find there might be one career that the two of you are actually agreeing on.
Mm-hmm.
So that maybe his number three is actually your number two. So you sit down. Based on the fact that both of you have at least an agreement in terms of one of the careers, discuss how far that career can take an individual. Give examples. You know, when you come with practical examples of people we can relate to in a society, you are able to give a child a mental picture of where they are going. But now when you say you just want someone to become a doctor, in that village, there's not even any doctor who this child can be able to look up to and be able to understand, okay, this is what a doctor does. But when we come up now with practical examples, be able to show him so-and-so went through this. And I believe if you go through that, based on the fact that you are resilient, you've gotten your C+, and C+ is the minimum for you to get into a university, it doesn't mean you are a failure. It means maybe one of the papers was hard. That one is the one that failed you.
Mm-hmm.
But since you are strong, your stronghold areas, you've done history well, you've done geography well, you've done, so you can go ahead and do courses that are more humanities. And now, from there, make a better decision.
Now, you've given a very interesting example,
mm-hmm.
that where I come from, mm-hmm. in my village, there is no doctor.
Mm-hmm.
So is it okay for someone's child or mm-hmm. daughter to say that because where I come from, there is no doctor, mm-hmm. I would like to be mm-hmm. the first doctor from my village?
It is very much okay. What we are saying is give this child a practical view. Bring that doctor whom now you know, who has been able to meet better challenges and be able to, even from a different community, say as much as we come from this community where there's no doctor, the first doctor from a certain community, let now that child understand the journey of that doctor. That's what I'm saying about being practical. Give us the real journey, what that doctor faced, rather than just saying, Ram Oguko is a journalist. I want you to be a journalist like Ram Oguko.
Mm-hmm.
Who is this Ram Oguko? Where did Ram Oguko grow up from? What has been his life? Give us at least the challenges that he has faced, so that even as an individual, as I go to school, I'll always remember Ram Oguko. Despite the fact that I've never met you,
mm-hmm.
I'll always aspire to now want to meet you, even as I try to maneuver my career just like yours.
Uh-huh,
yeah.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
So practicality. Let's not just throw names in the air.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And for a student,
mm-hmm.
A child that has just finished Form 4, mm-hmm. wants to join university, what are the things that they need to look out for to help them make that career choice for themselves?
True. First and foremost, like I had said, we have the grades that will determine. Right now, we are still waiting for their results from NEC.
Mm-hmm.
So the moment they'll be out with Kenya, unfortunately, it's all the grades. The grades is the one that determine which course you're going to undertake.
Yeah.
Right? So the moment we have a grade in place, then after that, I hear nowadays it's called CUSPS. It will be able, it replaced the former job. It will mm-hmm. be able to place mm-hmm. you into a certain course for you to do.
Mm-hmm.
Now, remember, that is not all that you have to do. If someone had told me when I entered into Kenyatta University around 7 years ago that I would be able, I can get into the university and still change my course, then I think, you see, now that is a part my parent did not, when she was giving me advice, mm-hmm. she did not also tell me that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you don't want, the moment you have been given this course, now go into the university, be real with yourself. Let
mm-hmm.
us not take a course that will also make you drain yourself at an extent that you now want to drop out at second year, at third
mm-hmm.
year.
Mm-hmm.
This is the grade you've gotten. Let's work with that grade. This is the course they have given you. Let's mm-hmm. work with that course. Go into the university, change that course.
Right.
Apply to change a course to the course that fits you within your own values, within your own interests. So that the question that we should be asking our children right now
mm-hmm.
is, what interests you as an individual? Rather than, what do you want to become when you grow up?
Okay.
What
okay.
interests you? From there, we are able now to help and guide them as parents. And you start that at an early age, so that even by the time we are now getting to Form 4, they now know the courses from the grades they are going to get, know the courses they are going to select, know how to change. You apply to the various administrative bodies, like in Kenyatta University, you apply to the admin section.
Mm-hmm.
At the UN, I believe it's also the same because...
Same thing, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So apply and have your grades change, have your schools changed from this course to that course.
And if you're doing that selection, mm-hmm. is it that you select based on your grade only, or is it that you can also do, there is something called bridging,
mm-hmm.
yeah? Can you go for that also as an option, or should it be that because I got this grade, mm-hmm. therefore, even though I wanted to become this, I should change again? Do we have that kind of flexibility?
I'll say that we have that kind of flexibility, but keeping in mind the fact that we are in Kenya, I can tell you of friends who did bridging courses, but at the end of the day, you find every time they apply for a job, this question always comes up. And you find an employer will, you know, my friend, she works at the Public Service Commission. She used to tell me, before I call you for an interview, I'll interact with your papers first. Mm-hmm. So the moment your paper comes forward, this person does not want to even give you a chance. Like, this is the sad reality. As much as that is what we will wish to happen, yeah. the sad reality in Kenya is that the moment someone sees you bridged biology, you bridge, your papers are first put aside. Let's try someone else first. Mm-hmm. Uyu, we'll call him. At some other time, but we are now asking. Mm-hmm. We are now looking for avenues where you still get what you want, but mm-hmm. at a faster rate, rather than having doors closed on you so many times.
By just the time, because you bridged.
Just because you bridged courses. So yes, it's an alternative. But to be honest with our viewers, is that it might. Don't be too optimistic. Just be open to the fact that the journey might take long, but mm-hmm. indeed you'll get there. So if you have the zeal, like I did, I mean, juggling the both degrees, you have the zeal, then you'll achieve it. It's just about remain focused. But if you, when you learn to, you want things quickly, bridging will still put you at
the
other side, mm-hmm. as other people are first being told, take a seat. Okay. You'll be told, stand kidogo apo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which can be discouraging.
And you start asking yourself,
frequently.
Yes, you start asking yourself, how less of a human being am I? It doesn't mean you are less. Sometimes ni kujikubali. Just let's not force ourselves into these careers. Remember, there's this KFC founder mm-hmm. who is celebrated to death. To date, this person was able, he was called Colonel Sanders. Mm-hmm. When he began his career, he did everything and anything. Every time, no accolades, no nothing, he was just doing every career that he could land on. By the time he was getting to 65 years old is when he realized he can start KFC. And here we are today. When I want something to eat, I'll go to KFC. So what I'm trying to say is that even these courses like chef, they'll take you places that advocacy, that being a doctor, that being a journalist might never ever have taken you.
So at the end of the day, it's not too late. Don't give up.
Mm-mm.
Even if you get that low grade, there's still that something that you can do for yourself.
Yes.
So you need to be flexible. You don't need to be rigid that this is what I wanted to be.
Be open to changes. Because even remember, even us who get into these careers, 2 years within our career, you feel like you now want to major and specialize in a particular area. So this is just something that will guide you, because they say education is powerful, education is the key to success. Mm-hmm. Just make sure you have your education materials right. The moment you come outside this world, so long as you have your degree, you can get into any kind of job specification and hack it well, compared to someone who even did law. We have clerks who never entered into law school, but these people are doing much better in law firms than people who went through law school.
Some commit suicide because of the issue of courses. You want to choose a course, but the course that you want is not the one that your parent wants. Suicide.
Or the job has given you.
Two, you have already chosen a course. Mm-hmm. You're in the middle of a semester, mm-hmm. but it's too much for you, mm-hmm. and you feel like you can't hack it. What would be your advice to such a person?
You're too young. You're still young. Life still has so much to offer. You'll be disappointed so many times. You'll disappoint yourself more than enough times. Does it mean you'll remain down there? Does it mean like you'll now decide that we are not going to move forward apart from the failures that I've gone through? So uh-huh. me, I'll tell you, take your time, change that course, move to another one, go and try what you feel you want.
So it's okay to
change.
There's no embarrassment.
There's no embarrassment, my friend. Go back to the time, because the only thing you're saying is that it will take a longer time. Mm-hmm. Do you know still 2021 will still come and pass anyway, whether you go back and do that course or not?
Wow. Mm-hmm. Wow. Baraka, mm-hmm. thank you so much. It is a pleasure. So it means that even if you've chosen a course in law, mm-hmm. and people are calling you lawyer, mm-hmm. you're just in your first semester, mm-hmm. first year, or something, this is a lawyer. It's not bad to change.
It is not. Follow your heart.
Follow your heart.
Kubali kuanguka. rather than you fall when you are, when you cannot be able to rise up again. You're still young. Tembesha you, Akili. Go everywhere. Find yourself.
That's all the time we had today. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Baraka, for joining me today. Mm-hmm. It was all about choosing a career for you. I hope that you've gotten the inspiration you need.
Yeah.
Baraka, a professional teacher, mm-hmm. a lawyer by profession, mm-hmm. actually an advocate of the High Court of Kenya, mm-hmm. and a YouTuber. I wonder how you've managed to juggle all of that at the same time, mm-hmm. considering also other responsibilities.
Yeah.
You are, she's an inspiration. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you too for having me. I hope we'll continue engaging in career, in talks such as this, just to make sure we change conversations mm-hmm. for our youths and for the better of the country.
We need to change mindsets. Mm-hmm. Make sure that you keep engaging with us. That's all the time we had today. But before we wrap it up, I'm seeing so many comments.